New Clark City is perhaps the Duterte administration's crown jewel for this 30th Southeast Asian Games. While its sports complex is at par with global standards and was completed in record time, the way it became to be was scrutinized by the government's corporate councils. A contract review in January 2018, former Office of the Government Corporate Council, or OGCC, Chief Rudolfo Rado, questions several provisions in the joint venture, or JV, between Basis Conversion and Development Authority, or BCDA, and Malaysian firm MTD Capital Berhad. But the OGCC's new chief, Elpidio Vega, says the contract review did not recommend halting the project at all.
I'd like to point out that in the first opinion or contract review by the OGCC, it already gave the go signal for BCDA to enter into such an agreement. It's just that there were some clarifications to be made in order that the same will be finally executed. But it did not say that BCDA should not go into this particular JBA.
The review penned by Jurado explicitly expresses concern the deal to build the sports facilities was a build-transfer scheme and not a joint venture. A build-transfer mode basically means a private firm constructs the facility, then the government pays for it with interest. A JV agreement, on the other hand, involves no payment. Parties may share profits for a certain period of time. In this case, the JV stipulates that BCDA will pay up the construction cost worth 8.5 billion pesos plus interest. BCDA says it will pay around 9.5 billion pesos for the sports facilities. This provision makes all the difference. The distinction also affects the mode of procurement. A build-transfer mode requires public bidding, while a JV leads to a Swiss challenge. The review adds, the legal effect brought by the difference in the frameworks cannot be overemphasized. BCDA Chief Vince Dizon defends the JV agreement.
After thorough review and study by both BCDA as well as our advisors from the Asian Development Bank, it was agreed with the advice of the ADB that the JV was the best and most practical, most transparent mode to do this project. It allows BCDA to simply leverage the land, the asset, no, and allows the developer to put in the capital for development.
Meanwhile, Vega has already issued a legal opinion clearing the JV of any legal obstacles on October 2, just a day after his appointment. BCDA and the OGCC both refused to give the press a copy of the allegedly favorable opinion. With all the legal questions in New Clark, it is likely to go under the scrutiny of Congress after the SEA Games. Another question is, what happens to the sports facilities when the games wrap up? Dizon admits that MTD Capital Berhad never intended to build the sports complex in its unsolicited proposal. It was BCDA that asked the Malaysian firm to include the project in light of the Philippines hosting the SEA Games.
The only issue were the sports facilities, because the developer never proposed to build the sports facilities in 2018. Building sports facilities for the developer at a point where there is no critical mass in a city yet is not commercially viable. And that's also what ADB told us. Building a stadium, an aquatic center, is not commercially viable. Government has to come in to build it. That's the only way. There is no other way to build them, especially in the timeline that was given.
Getting to the world-class facility is quite daunting, as it is several miles away from the town proper in Capas, Tarlac. Visitors complain of the limited commercial establishments there. The challenge now is to transform New Clark into a new urban center. Getting to New Clark City is a big challenge for now, and that means it's going to take a while for it to realize its full economic and cultural potential. Because more structures are needed to be built around it, more money needed to be spent, and more contracts to be signed. All the more reason for Filipinos and the press to keep an even more watchful eye. Ralph Rivas Rappler, Manila.